Sociopath is a trending word right now thanks to Shane Dawson's The Mind of Jake Paul series and the response from Jake, his family, as well as the wider internet. While Shane's subject is Jake, he has regularly mentioned his brother, and a lot of the characteristic traits of a sociopath can also be applied to Logan too. So, while Shane is busy looking at Jake, we're going to shift our attention to the other Paul brother for one second as we ask, is Logan Paul a sociopath? Hello and welcome back to Life's Biggest Questions, where today we are picking up on the trending topic of sociopaths. I'm your host Rebecca Felgate, and I want to ask you before we get into this video whether or not you think the Pauls are sociopaths. Also, are there other celebrities out there that you also think fit the bill? Let me know in the comments section down below. Also, if you like this type of video, do make sure you give us a good thumbs up and share this video with a friend. If you want to connect with the team that went into making this video, then there are links to our social medias in the description box. So, sociopaths. As of the publication of this video, there have been three parts of Shane Dawson's series. Part 2 was almost entirely dedicated to the psychology of the sociopath, in which some really interesting points were raised by therapist Katie Morton. She said that 1 in 25 people fits the criteria of sociopath, and she identifies those traits so we can spot them. Some people might be asking why it even matters, but I suppose what Shane and Katie are getting at is that it matters because sociopaths are not who they present themselves to be. While it is certainly an antisocial behavioral disorder, sociopaths seemingly do not have the ability to love. It is also thought that the 4% of the population that are suspected to be sociopaths are responsible for 50% of the crimes. To determine whether or not Logan Paul is a sociopath, we are going to hold him up to the key traits that Katie identifies and see if he fits the bill. So these traits are a god complex, a charming, charismatic personality, intensity, spontaneity, a controlling and manipulative and dominating personality, high intelligence, a lack of guilt, remorse, and empathy, and a tendency to lie. Like Logan said in his recent video, Dear Shane Dawson, perhaps the labeling of sociopath is pretty black and white, and instead it is more of a sliding scale. So we're going to decide where Logan fits on that scale, and then I guess you can decide whether or not that matters to you. One of the key traits is a grandiose sense of self-worth, and well, come on, this one is truly obvious. Logan Paul is arrogant. It's not like he doesn't have reason to be proud of himself. He does have an empire of 18 million YouTube subscribers and a successful clothing brand, as well as a host of acting credentials. That being said, he's in no way humble and has often labeled himself as the greatest YouTuber of all time, saying that he will one day overtake PewDiePie. Put it this way, his self-belief is off the charts, so it really is a big tick there. This leads me to the charming and charismatic thing. What we can absolutely call Logan charismatic, his arrogance kind of gets in the way of him yielding any charm. He does not come across as universally likable, which is something that a sociopath would aim to be. But, big but, that being said, he himself has claimed that the way he acts is in order to gain views, and actually, he does in some way seem charming to the people he meets one-on-one, so maybe he's just realized that arrogance sells better than charm, which would be a realization a sociopath would have. Nonetheless, if we're going to be textbook about this, I don't think we can award him charm, so it's 2 out of 3 so far. Sociopaths have a history of early behavioral problems. While it has been claimed that his brother was more of a bully than he was, some people have accused him of not being kind. Some things may have been covered up in the past, but nonetheless, with what evidence we have, we can't really necessarily say he had a background of behavioral issues. Sociopaths are supposed to be emotional imitators and will often make grand but hollow gestures to try and present normal emotion, but often they go overboard in trying to prove they have these feelings. It doesn't seem genuine. Evidence of this can maybe be found in Logan's I gave my mum $10,000 for Christmas video, or some of the videos he's made with his ex-girlfriends, but he is nowhere as guilty of this as his brother with the whole Jerrica thing. That being said, that has been successful for Jake. I note that Logan is now involved with Clogan, sweeping new girlfriend Chloe Bennett away on a vacation to Paris and declaring he loves her just after a short period of dating. He's posted Instagram odes to her, although it seems a little less performative than his brother's romance, so I'm gonna give him a 0.5 for this, which means he's on 2.5 out of 5. Steady as he goes. Okay, this is where it gets more convincing. Sociopaths are intense, impulsive, and spontaneous to the point of compulsion. Logan Paul is extremely intense and very impulsive. He just bought a micro pig, a snowplow. He buys ridiculous things like massive ball pits and spends a whole day jumping around in them. He's elaborate, and a lot of his decisions don't seem to be well thought out. That being said, he's no ordinary guy. He's a YouTuber and has made his name on being spontaneous and seemingly reckless. Is this the way he is in real life, or is this just a performance? I can only go with what we know and what is shown, so for now, without knowing the real him, if there is one, we have to give him this. Here is the scariest bit about sociopaths. They have no empathy. They feel no guilt or shame and show no remorse. This is the side of the personality disorder that makes sociopaths more able criminals. It is a normal human emotion to feel empathy for others, and it has been said that there have been worrying instances where Logan has seemed devoid of this key humanizing trait. The big example here, of course, is his suicide forest video. 1. Does a person who feels empathy go into a known suicide spot dressed like this? 2. Do they goof around before entry? And is this their reaction to seeing a person hanging? Ladies and gentlemen, this is a person with no shame and no empathy. A huge tick. Afterwards, he put on a good show of feeling shame and remorse in his apology video, but this video would not have been made if he'd never been called out. He was also very quick to get back to business as usual. Many say this was performance of remorse and not true remorse, and actually I have to agree. I remember reading an article saying that his redemption arc following his fight with KSI was going exactly as planned. I'm not sure exactly, but I think we're on 11 out of 13 for the sociopath versus not. Next, we move on to the need to dominate and control others and win at all costs. We don't know as much about his private life, and he has been at the center of less friend loss and bullying scandals than his brother, but if his fight with KSI and the dialogue surrounding it says anything, I would say that, yeah, this applies. Does that make it 13 out of 15-ish? I can't tell you if he's a gifted liar because I'm not personally involved with him, so we're gonna have to leave that one out for now. This does leave one pretty key point. High intelligence. A lot of sociopaths are said to be pretty intelligent, and this is where a lot of critics will breathe a sigh of relief, for it seems that only a fool would be stupid enough to film a dead man in a forest and call it a good business idea. But let us be reminded that intelligence comes in many different forms. Sociopaths are not emotionally intelligent. They do not understand empathy, as we know. They can only play at it. I hate to say it, but Logan is clearly intelligent in a number of key ways. If he were not business savvy, he simply couldn't garner a following of nearing 20 million and build a successful clothing brand. Yes, he made an empathetically stupid mistake, but remember that redemption arc from the fight? It couldn't have been scripted any better. If you don't like the conversation, change it. Control it. Smart move, Logan. Smart move. So, all things considered, by my count, Logan fulfills around 14 of around 17 or so sociopathic traits, which may not render him black and white 100% sociopath, but if it is a sliding scale, he is, I had to say it, at the higher end. But we are going on what we see, and I guess only those truly close to him would be able to tell you for sure. In Logan's Dear Shane Dawson video, he asks why it even matters. He says, if your friend has sociopathic tendencies, he's not gonna stab you in the middle of the night when you're not looking. And sure, maybe he won't, but it might mean that your friend doesn't really care about you, does not feel emotionally invested in you, and that you are a disposable object or tool to them. The question is, how comfortable does that make you feel? A further question I would love to explore is why sociopaths seem to be so successful in business. Do regular human emotions set us back in the workplace? If we can spot a sociopath, does this mean that we could be more mindful to allow those who do have feelings to succeed too? Or have we paved our own way to a robot takeover? Alright. That may have been a bit dramatic, but these are all of the kinds of questions we love asking here at Life's Biggest Questions. So stay tuned for more coming soon, and do let me know your thoughts on this big answer. If you like this video, do make sure you show me by giving it a good thumbs up, sharing it with a friend, and staying subscribed for more Most Amazing Lists. I'm your host, Rebecca Folgate. Make sure you stay curious, stay alert, and never ever stop questioning.